Rest in peace, His Royal Highness Prince Philip. 영국 시각으로 4월 9일 오전 윈저성에서 영면한 영국 여왕의 남편에 관한 소식입니다. 별도의 설명 없이 긴급 뉴스 직접 들어보시겠습니다.
This is BBC News. We're interrupting our schedules for the following announcement. Buckingham Palace has announced the death of His Royal Highness, the Duke of Edinburgh. A statement from Buckingham Palace said, "It is with deep sorrow that Her Majesty the Queen has announced the death of her beloved husband, His Royal Highness Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh. His Royal Highness passed away peacefully this morning at Windsor Castle."
지난 한 주간 다루었던 뉴스입니다. 다시 한번 들으시면서 모르는 것이 나오면 확인하시고 자신의 것으로 만들어 실력 향상을 도모하시기 바랍니다. 오늘의 뉴스는 시험적으로 대규모의 관중을 행사에 입장시키려는 영국 소식입니다. 어느 경기에 시범 적용이 될지, 누구에게 입장이 허용이 될지 알아보시기 바랍니다.
The government is planning a series of pilots to allow large crowds into public events in England, but only if people can prove they've been vaccinated or they're clear of coronavirus. Next month's FA Cup final at Wembley is expected to take part in the trials. The Prime Minister says the COVID status certification scheme will help people return to the things they love. The government is planning a series of pilots to allow large crowds into public events in England, but only if people can prove they've been vaccinated or they're clear of coronavirus. Next month's FA Cup final at Wembley is expected to take part in the trials. The Prime Minister says the COVID status certification scheme will help people return to the things they love.
오늘의 뉴스는 추가적으로 이동 제한 조치를 완화할 예정인 스코틀랜드 소식입니다. 추가로 영업을 재개할 수 있는 업종은 어떻게 되는지 알아보시기 바랍니다.
Scotland has taken further steps towards relaxing lockdown restrictions. From today, homeware shops and garden centres can reopen, as well as non-essential click and collect services. Hairdressers and barbers with shop fronts can also reopen, but by appointment only. Scotland has taken further steps towards relaxing lockdown restrictions. From today, homeware shops and garden centres can reopen, as well as non-essential click and collect services. Hairdressers and barbers with shop fronts can also reopen, but by appointment only.
오늘의 뉴스는 동경올림픽 참가 여부에 관한 입장을 발표한 북한 소식입니다. 참가 여부는 어떻게 되고 그 결정의 배경은 무엇인지 알아보시기 바랍니다.
North Korea has announced that it will not take part in the Tokyo Olympics, the first country to pull out of the event. Pyongyang said it had taken the decision to protect its athletes from the coronavirus. North Korea has announced that it will not take part in the Tokyo Olympics, the first country to pull out of the event. Pyongyang said it had taken the decision to protect its athletes from the coronavirus.
오늘의 뉴스는 코로나 바이러스 환자에 대한 연구를 진행한 옥스퍼드 대학에 관한 소식입니다. 연구진들이 발견한 사항은 무엇인지 알아보시기 바랍니다.
Researchers from Oxford University in Britain, who examined the records of a quarter of a million patients in the United States, found that people who'd had coronavirus were more likely to have a brain illness. The authors say it suggests COVID is not just a respiratory virus, but also has a direct effect on brain tissue and blood vessels. Researchers from Oxford University in Britain, who examined the records of a quarter of a million patients in the United States, found that people who'd had coronavirus were more likely to have a brain illness. The authors say it suggests COVID is not just a respiratory virus, but also has a direct effect on brain tissue and blood vessels.
오늘의 뉴스는 아스트라제네카 백신 사용을 제한하는 호주에 관한 소식입니다. 무슨 이유로 어떤 제한을 두고 이를 대체하는 것은 어떤 백신인지 알아보시기 바랍니다.
Australia has become the latest country to limit the use of the AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccine because of a possible link with rare cases of blood clotting. The Prime Minister, Scott Morrison, said in a late-night press conference that people under the age of 50 should be given the Pfizer vaccine instead. Australia has become the latest country to limit the use of the AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccine because of a possible link with rare cases of blood clotting. The Prime Minister, Scott Morrison, said in a late-night press conference that people under the age of 50 should be given the Pfizer vaccine instead.
시청해 주셔서 감사합니다. 다음 시간에 뵙겠습니다.